Welcome back. Hello again. This is my second video with HipKit Club. I'm really excited to share this project with you. We are going to make page flags. I'm making 4 page flag embellishments. I will let you know throughout the video what is mostly everything is in the kit as usual, except for the trim. Oh, before I keep going, let me apologize about my right hand. So I have hot glue gun burns all over my right hand, and they look gross, and I'm sorry. I was hoping they would be better by now. I didn't really want to put a Band-Aid on because then, I don't know, I think the Band-Aids look just as bad as the cut. I'm sorry, it's 3 little burns for my hot glue gun. Just don't look at them. Look at what I'm making, not at my hand. I always have problems with my hands. Okay, so again, thank you for watching. I will go over what items are not included. All of these papers are included. So I have, that's a little banner die or a banner punch, and I use it all the time to make these page flags. But if you can see, the only shape I used from it was the top shape, the one I'm folding now. The other ones I used it on, but I just hand cut different measurements. They're just eyeball it. I'd like them to all be a little uneven. So you'll see some, the middle one's a little bit longer, the bottom one's a little bit shorter. And I just play with the different ends. So I stick it in one end and it gives it like an arrow. And then the other end gives it a page, like a ribbon bottom, a page flag. And I sometimes, it's hard to kind of tell at the moment, but sometimes when I fold them in half, I fold the top one a little bit shorter, so if it's double-sided paper and I'm not using the barcode piece, when I use the barcode piece, I can't do that, but I'll fold it a little bit shorter so you can see the opposite side of the paper, like a little border for the tip of it. I did it in a few of them, I think 2 or 3 of the top ones and a couple of the smaller ones on the bottoms. Now I'm just getting my trim out. This, again, the trim is from my stash. That's some tool that I use just to add some texture. I try to put trim or tool or both on each page flag. So I don't get carried away, but I try to do one piece, one little banner with a tool, and then another piece with maybe some trim. I do put stitching around every single one. So it's going so fast you can't really see it, but there's stitching around everyone. The way that I get the tool to stay on is I stitch it around. That's what's when I go off screen for a split second. I fast forward. This took me an hour and a half to do, and I cut it down to a 12-minute video for you guys. So you're not seeing and waiting for me to stitch. I just stitched them all, so they are all now stitched. Some of them I did zigzaggy stitches down the center. You can see I put trim on a lot of, or on I think 4, right. So each one has a trim, and each one has some type of the tool on there. This pom-pom is actually pom-pom trim that I cut down. I love this pom-pom trim. It's my favorite pom-pom trim. It's from Hobby Lobby, and I use it all the time. I absolutely love it. So now I skip past this part too. I just show you the first one or two, but I glue them all down with my hot glue gun. And I usually, when I do these, I don't do 4 at a time. I do 1 at a time and then go to the next one and then do another one and go to the next one. But for this video, I wanted to do more than just 1. So that's also why I had to speed it up so much. I didn't want you guys to get bored. Now, this part I don't normally do. Also, I'm laying, kind of giving myself a little blueprint layout of what I want to do and how I want to use it. So the chipboard is from the kit as well. And I just kind of layer out. I will link all the kits that I used below, absolutely. I just kind of layered them. And the smallest ones are best for these little page flags because they're little. But if you, I've done a bigger page flag for a banner, and I made one of the banner pieces pretty much a whole flag, and then I used some of the bigger chipboard. I also, I don't know if you saw, I peeled the sticky part off of the back of the chipboard because I repositioned it so many times. I cannot make my mind up. One of these took me like 15 minutes. I fast forwarded it. I kept taking it on, putting it off, putting it on, taking it off, putting it on. I put the double-sided tape down to help the little like twiny stuff stick to the chipboard. And then I back it. This one I don't think I back, but the other one I back with hot glue and a little piece of paper. So that little lemonade, pink lemonade, is an exclusive to the club. And of course the glue goes everywhere and I have little spider strings all over the place. This, I wasn't sure if I wanted to put trim. I ended up doing an accordion fold on some vellum. And when I do my accordion folds, I do one side and then I flip it over. And it makes it so much easier to do the fold because one of the folds is going in and one of the folds going out, if that makes sense at all. But it just fan folds better that way. I used to only do the top, all the tops, and it was harder for me to fold it back. So then I flipped it over and I do every other. So every other one on the top, I flip it over, every other one on the bottom. I hope that makes sense when you watch this. I'm sorry. And I did also stitch. You can barely see it. I stitched around or just the top layer of the acetate or the vellum before I accordion. No, after I put the score lines in it. I've done it both ways. I've stitched first and then put the score lines in it. They both work. I don't really have a preference. It works fine. These hearts, they don't have these exact hearts anymore in the kit because there was a defect in them, but they have, I think it's doodlebug hearts in their place, and I love the hearts. The hearts are really cute. I think they're both epoxy hearts with a little bit of shine to them, so they're really pretty. I add so many layers on here, but you just keep layering. Some of them you can barely see, so when I cover the stuff up, I stitched on every single one of those banners, but sometimes you don't even end up seeing it. The one I just did, the Sand and Sun, is the middle piece of that banner is completely covered up. If you look at this one on the top, you can see what I meant by when I fold it back a little bit shorter than a perfect fold in half. That way you can see the two layers. And this one was driving me crazy. I kept changing my mind. I don't even know how many times. The cherries end up not making the cut. I moved the cherries, although it just looked cute there, so I should have just left them there. It's hard when you're crafting. When I watch myself, I've said this before on my channel, when I watch myself craft, I feel like I do the same thing when I watch other people. I'm like, yeah, that looks good. That looks good. And then they take it away. And then I'm like, yeah, that looks good. And then they take it away. So I literally just did the same thing. The cherries look fine. But at the moment when I'm actually doing it, for whatever reason, it just didn't feel right. So I took them off. Now I wish I put them back on because they looked cute there, but I still like the way this one turned out. Again, lots of little subtle layers. The yellow trim is, I cannot remember where that's from. I'm using the hearts again. Oh, there's some sequins that I glue down on there. It's hard. It's tricky when you're using the glue gun for the little sequins because it runs. If you look at that little tool to my right, it's a ceramic tool. I don't actually know what it's called, but I use that to pick off the extra glue once I'm done. That way there's no glue like squished out on the sides. So again, I didn't show you the fan fold because I showed you the first time, but I did the same thing. I stitched it again the same way as last time. I used the zigzag stitch, and I put it on the bottom instead of the top. For this, I wanted to give it an extra layer. It looked kind of flat to me just to put on the accordion, so I took some more trim from my stash and stitched, you can't see it, but I just stitched it down to that so there's gold thread going right through the center of the Fearless. And then, of course, I'm like moving it around a million times off. Oh, and I'm sorry about you can see my little cheaty table now on the top left. You know my secret, that's not actually my crafting table. My crafting table is the wood table underneath, but it looks better on the white background, I feel. So it's they're floorboards that I use as my table. So if you're trying to take cute photos, you can always get fake outs. They also sell backdrops as well if you're trying to take photos of your projects on Amazon. But these are some puffy dots I had from my stash. And I needed to raise, because there's the chipboard little shell, I had to raise the accordion up because it wouldn't sit flush against the paper. So now I'm just building my layers as usual. The butterfly, I love the butterfly. I love the colors. I find I don't grab yellow that often, but I absolutely love the way it looks, especially with pink. It reminds me of watermelon and lemonade. But I never use it. So now that I have some, see, I just fixed it. Now you can't see it, my cheat spot. Now that I have yellow and pink in this kit and in the Sunny Days collection, I'm forced to use it, and I'm so glad because I love it and I don't normally gravitate towards it. Even though when I see other people use it, it always looks amazing. So this is my last one. Again, I fast forwarded it, but I skipped it a little bit. I was struggling with where to put the shells on top of the word, behind the word, on top of the word, behind the word. So I end up sticking the shell on top of that little phrase sticker. That also, those stickers are from the Sunny Days collection, which is a part of the March kits. And the reason why, I don't know if I mentioned it before, the reason why I put the tape back there is to keep the, I think I did say it, the twine, that's what happens when you do these videos. I forget what I say, I'm just watching and repeating, I'm sorry. That one I glued down with the hot glue gun. So sometimes it pops up, it doesn't really stick very long because it's been twisted on the like little spool. So it just wants to pop off that whatever it is I'm using. So I glue it down so it doesn't move anywhere. The little bathing suit is also from the Sunny Days collection. Now I'm gonna piece it all together. Those cherries tried to make their appearance again, but they got the boot. I had my own personal stash of this collection. I still have not used those cherries. I don't know why I cannot use the cherries, but I am determined to use them, maybe on my next project. This is it. Thank you very much for watching. I hope you enjoyed it. I hope I inspired you to try to make some page flags or any type of embellishments. Thank you for your support. Thank you, thank you, thank you. And happy crafting. I had a really good time making these. I love the way they turned out. My next project with Hip Kit Club, I'm actually going to use one of these in the project. So I'm excited to tie one item to the next. So that's my little cheat tool that I told you about. I'm showing you that I'm picking out the glue. And yes, thank you very much. And this is the awkward silence part, but it's going to shut off in a moment. I ran out of stuff to say. Thank you, everybody. Enjoy. Happy crafting.